Welcome to the Great Exodus series. God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go. The path to Mount Zion. Come out of the world and out of Babylon onto the new path, the narrow path, the middle path, the path to your glory and the path to paradise. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is the bride in the millennium. Many people say that the bride will return with Jesus to be in the millennium. But if you read the book of Revelation carefully, then first you will see that the bride will be a pillar in heaven. Not on earth, not in another realm, not on Mount Zion, but in heaven. And when the escape of the bride will take place, what will be very, very soon now, then they will go to the third heaven. Now, it does not make any sense at all if the bride goes to heaven and then comes back onto a corrupt world. But because during the millennium, the world is still corrupt. And the world is still under bad influence. And only when Satan had a second term, and only when Satan will then be completely defeated and destroyed, then the world is ready for heaven to come down onto earth. And this we see with the return of New Jerusalem, and then new heaven and new earth. And when you read this passage in the Revelation, at the end of Revelation, you see that the Spirit and the Bride say, come. And you see that there is written a passage that says that New Jerusalem is a bride. Yes, because a bride is a pillar in heaven. A New Jerusalem is a heavenly abode of the Father. So when New Jerusalem, heaven, comes down onto earth, then the bride will return. The bride will not return for the millennium. Who will be then in the millennium going with the Lord wherever he goes? And who will also help him? Not only in the fifth trumpet seal time period, but also thereafter in the millennium. First of all, the 144,000, as it is written, Revelation 14. They will go wherever Jesus is going. But then also the people who are in paradise, who are on Mount Zion, because once Mount Zion has been established on earth, it will remain on earth. So the people who have their mansions in or on Mount Zion, they will also be the people who will help Jesus during the millennium. So that will be the remnant church that will go into the rapture at the sixth seal. These are the people who will also be during the millennium on earth. Not the bride. The bride will go before everything starts, before the great exodus, before the seals are opening. The bride will escape to the third heaven and will then return at the end with New Jerusalem, for the time of the white throne judgment and a new heaven and a new earth. What also makes perfectly sense. Because Jesus' bride will never be put again into the fire, into the line during the millennium, when there are still so many bad nations are there. Not everybody will follow Jesus, even if he is the king of the world, during the millennium. That's the reason why Satan becomes the second term. Because there's still a lot of evil things on this earth. And Jesus will never take his bride and put them into the line of fire. The bride will come down with New Jerusalem when everything is completed and finished. And everything is restored. Not very difficult to see that in the book of Revelation, if you read carefully. I hope this clarifies the position about the bride and if the bride is part of the millennium. Thank you for listening to this topic. My name is Michael and I wish you a blessed day and hope that you will return tomorrow for the next topic. Maranatha.